Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. This is part 7 of synthetic division, and we're going to do the following division problem using synthetic division and then check the answer. Right, so what we have is 7 minus 3x squared plus 9x cubed divided by 3x plus 2. Since we're dividing by a linear factor, notice there's no x squared term or x cubed term, just 3x plus 2. We can use synthetic division. And we have a polynomial here in the numerator. We want to write the polynomial in descending order. So let's rewrite this like that. We'll start with the highest degree, 9x cubed. So we have 9x cubed. And then we look for the x squared term, that's a minus 3x squared. Then we look for the x term, and there is none. So remember, we need to put 0x, and then the constant term is plus 7. And I'm going to write it as divided by 3x plus 2. Now, because this is the same thing, I could write division with this big fraction bar or with a division symbol. Okay, so what we do first is we're going to take what we're dividing by and set it equal to 0. And that is the number, whatever x equals, that's the number we put in the little box here. Then we have to remember one more thing. This was not just x plus 2, it was 3x plus 2. So at the end, we have to divide the quotient of our answer by 3. Okay, so we're going to have to remember to do that. Divide the coefficients of quotient by 3. So when we do the synthetic division, we're going to look at those quotients and divide by 3 before we write our final answer. Okay, so now we've got 9x cubed minus 3x squared plus 0x plus 7. So in order, we need to write the coefficients, the x cubed term, the x squared term, and I want to say actually the coefficient of the x cubed term, the coefficient of the x squared term, the coefficient of the x term, and the constant. If you have something to the third power, there will be four numbers here. Okay, and we draw our line, and remember, down here will be our remainder. Okay, so why don't you try this on your own first? Put the video on pause and see if you can get the answer. Divide out by 3 and write the answer and check it. Put the video on pause for a little while. Try it all on your own and then come back and see how you did. Okay, step one. We're going to bring down the 9 and we multiply that by negative 2/3. Now, if you can't do that in your head, then go ahead and just write it down. What is negative 2/3 times 9? Well, it's going to be a negative, right? So you know it's going to be a negative something. And let's see what cancels. The 3 goes into the 9, so conveniently we get a whole number. That's very nice. Negative 2 times 3 is negative 6. And then we add down. Negative 3 plus negative 6 is negative 9. Now we're going to multiply that negative 9 by the number in the box. So we're going to have to do negative 9 times negative 2/3. Now, when you multiply a negative times a negative, it will be a positive. And all you're doing here, you're still doing 2/3 times 9. So hopefully you see that's also going to be plus 6. But if you need to, write it over out here on the side. Negative 2/3 times negative 9, you'll get positive 6. And then we add down. 0 plus 6 is 6. And then we have to multiply that 6 by the negative 2/3. All right, so we might need a little bit of room for that. Here we go. Oops, a little bit more space. There we go. So let's do that. How about negative 2/3 times positive 6? So we can see the answer is going to be negative again, right? And then what cancels here? 3 goes into 6 twice, so that's negative 4. So it ended up being negative 4. And we add to get 3. So this is the remainder. But we have to remember, Because the coefficient of the original number had a 3, we have to divide all these coefficients out here by 3. Not the remainder, just the coefficients of the quotient. Right, so there's the remainder, constant term, x squared term. So the x squared term is 9 over 3. 3x squared minus 9 over 3, that's the x term. 6 over 3, that's plus 2, plus the remainder over what we divided by. All right, now what do we divide by? Let's go back up here. We divided by 3x plus 2, right? That's what you divided by. 3x plus 2. So that looks to be our answer. Now we want to make sure, so we're going to check the answer. So remember how you check it? You take this number down here, which is what you divided by, the 3x plus 2, multiply it by the quotient, this 3x squared minus 3x plus 2, and then we're going to just add the remainder of 3. That's how you also check division with numbers, by the way. Remember if you did like 11 divided by 3, you would say, well, 3 goes into 11 3 times and 2 remainder. You could write that as 3 and 2 thirds. Remember, you put the remainder over the 3, what you were dividing by. But it's just that we have this shortcut and write it as 3 and 2 thirds. To check it, you would say 3 times 3 is 9 plus 2. That gets you back to 11. Exactly the same thing with long division. So that's what we're going to do. We're going to see what 3x squared minus 3x plus 2 times the 3x plus 2, and then we have to add the remainder. And we want to make sure the answer is what we divided by originally. Okay, so lots of ways to multiply that out. Here's a traditional method. Just multiply that by 3x plus 2. I did the box method in my other videos, but I thought do something different just so you could see there's more than one way to do this. So if 2 times 2 is 4, 2 times negative 3x is negative 6x, and 2 times 3x squared is 6x squared. All right, so that's just multiplying 2 times the whole numerator. Now we're going to do 3x times everything. 3x times 2 is plus 6x. 3x times negative 3x is a negative 9x squared. And 3x times 3x squared is 9x cubed. So if we add up, we get 9x cubed minus 3x squared. That's a 0, right? Negative 6x plus 6x plus 4. So let's go back up here and write that. 9x cubed minus 3x squared plus 4 is what we got when we multiplied those two polynomials together. But I have to remember, add on this remainder of 3. So we have 9x cubed minus 3x squared plus 7. So the question is, was that the original? There it is. 9x cubed plus 3x squared plus 7. 9x, oops, wait a minute. Yes, 9x squared minus 3x squared plus 7, and we got here 9x cubed minus 3x squared plus 7, so it checked. Therefore, our answer right here is correct. Wow, okay, so we've done a lot of synthetic division problems. You don't need to know synthetic division, you could always do long division. This is just a quick, fun, easy way of doing division when you're taking a polynomial and dividing it by a linear polynomial, which means that most two terms, right? And no exponent on the x except just to the first power. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.